Hello and welcome to my channel. This video is about introduction to bookkeeping and I will talk about DEADCLIC accounts and the three principles of accounting. Let's start with the DEADCLIC, which is commonly used by learners who are studying accounting. The acronym DEADCLIC stands for Debit, Expenses, Assets, Drawings, Credit, Liabilities, Income, and Capital. There are three types of accounts in the debit side and three types of accounts in the credit side. Different accounts used in the business are sorted into these six types of accounts. Now let's take a look at some examples. In the debit side, we still have assets, expenses, and drawings. And on the credit side, we still have liabilities, income, and capital. We are still looking at the DEADCLIC here. I just exchanged the places of the assets and expenses. I just prefer to do that. But there is no difference in the DEADCLIC as they are still both in the debit side. So these are just examples. There could be more accounts used in the business or there could be less. It depends on the nature of the business. Now let's go to the three principles of accounting. We have separate entity, dual effect, and accounting equation. Separate entity means the company is a separate entity from its owner. And in accounting, we are looking at the company's point of view. Dual effect means all business transactions have dual effect. They affect the debit and the credit side. The debit entry should always be equal to the opposite credit entry. For example, the owner invested $10,000 to the company. The bank account increases by $10,000, it goes to debit, and the capital increases by $10,000, it goes to credit. The dual effect is increase in asset and increase in capital. For accounting equation, we have assets equals liabilities plus equity. For example, the value of our asset is 500, our liabilities is 300, and the equity is 200. When we use these values in different forms of equation, the values are still the same and the equation is still correct. So let me explain to you briefly what does this equation mean. Assets are everything that the company owns, but not all assets belong to the owner. A portion of the assets belong to the creditors. So in different terms used, assets equals creditors' equity plus owner's equity. This is just the same equation. The liabilities is the creditors' equity. It's the portion of the assets that belongs to the creditors. The equity or owner's equity, sometimes you may encounter owner's capital or capital. They all mean the same. It's the portion of the assets that belongs to the owner. Now let's associate the accounting equation to the DEADCLIC. In the equation, the assets is on the left side, and in the DEADCLIC, the assets is on the left side as well, or on the debit side. In the equation, the liabilities is on the right side, and on the DEADCLIC, the liabilities is on the right side as well, or on the credit side. In the equation, the equity is on the right side. However, there is no equity in our DEADCLIC. We only have these four remaining accounts. It's expenses, drawings, income, and capital. So let's see what the equity consists of. The equity is a capital minus drawings plus profit. So we can see the drawings and the capital. The profit is income minus expenses. So let's expand the equity further. The equity is capital minus drawings plus income minus expenses. Now we can see all these four remaining accounts. So the equity is on the right side of the equation, and the income and capital are on the right side of the DEADCLIC as well, or on the credit side. Now you might be wondering why expenses and drawings are on the debit side. Clearly, they are not assets, and if they are a part of the equity, they should go to the credit as well. However, if you notice the minuses in the drawings and expenses, it means they are deducted from the equity. It means they lessen the equity or decreases the equity. So if the income and capital increases the equity and they go to credit, the expenses and drawings that decreases the equity goes to the opposite side, which is debit. Now that we know why these accounts are in debit or in credit, DEADCLIC is a very useful tool. However, you have to be very careful in using it. You have to remember that assets, expenses, and drawings only goes to debit when they increase. Similarly, the liabilities, income, and capital only goes to credit when they increase. When these accounts decrease, they go to the opposite side. So if you use DEADCLIC in your studies, don't forget to analyze first whether the accounts increase or decrease in the transaction before entering them into either debit or credit side. For example, if you encounter a transaction that involves a bank account, you might immediately think it's an asset and it goes to debit, which is incorrect. As I have said earlier, you have to analyze first whether it increases or decreases in the transaction. To understand what I'm saying, let's take a look at some example transactions. Example 1, owner invested $10,000 to the company. To find out the correct entry for this transaction, let's answer three simple questions. What are the accounts involved? What is the dual effect? And where to put the entry when the account increases or decreases? So while answering these questions, we will use the DEADCLIC. For the first question, what are the accounts involved? It's the bank and the capital. The $10,000 goes to the bank, and that $10,000 is now the company's available capital. Second question, what is the dual effect? Bank is an asset, so we have increase in asset and increase in capital. Third question, where to put the entry when the account increases or decreases? When an asset increases, it goes to debit, and when the capital increases, it goes to credit. The dual effect of a transaction, however, doesn't always have to be an asset and a capital, or asset and liabilities. It could be two assets. And we will see that in our next example. Example 2, purchase of office equipment from cash at bank amounting to $500. What are the accounts involved here? It's office equipment and bank. The value of the new office equipment is $500, and $500 is deducted from the bank to buy the new office equipment. What is the dual effect? Our office equipment account increases and our bank account decreases. Both of the accounts are asset, so we have an increase in asset and decrease in asset. Where to put the entry when the account increases or decreases? When an asset increases, it goes to debit, and when an asset decreases, it goes to the opposite side, which is credit. So I hope now you understand the dual effect and how to use DEADCLIC. It is also important to remember the accounting equation, to be familiarized with the different accounts, and to be able to classify what types of account they are. And that's it for this video. I hope you find it useful. If you have any questions or suggestions, please comment down below. If you want to watch more videos like this, please don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.